What's up, guys? Pete Moriarty here. I have a massive announcement from Google. They have just actually announced that Google Meet is going to be available free, free for the world, free for everyone. And in this video, I'm going to take you through what that means, how you can get access to it, and all of the details on this, including my thoughts on the new SKU of G Suite Essentials. That one is super duper exciting. Google Meet is part of G Suite, and usually you have to be a part of the G Suite world to get access to Google Meet, right? But a lot has changed in the last little while. You know, Google's not really had that much success with Google Meet in terms of the small business space, because many businesses, they were burnt when they used Google Hangouts in the past, and you know, it kind of left a bad taste in everyone's mouth. And so a few years ago now, Google actually rebooted Hangouts and rebuilt it as Google Meet, and it was much better quality, much faster, much easier to use, great new apps on the mobile phone. But for many businesses, they were still using Zoom, still using Skype, still using other platforms, because that Hangouts reputation was just kind of like still lingering for businesses. And Google have now made Meet into a really, really great product. We've been using it for a long time, recommending it to all of our customers for a long time. But there's still this big elephant in the room that Zoom is just so damn popular, and so many people seem to be using Zoom. Even businesses that are using G Suite are still using Zoom, and I know this from our colleagues and from our customers. Now, I understand it. Zoom has a couple of features that Meet just doesn't have. One of those is gallery view, there's the breakout rooms, there's a few other bits and pieces there. But in the last few months, in the current economic climate, there have been some big shifts in perception for Zoom because of all the security issues that have actually come up for them. And so a business that's going through tremendous scale is starting to have some issues around security. And myself personally, I know that I would much prefer to trust my confidentiality of my meetings with a company like Google than a company like Zoom. Anyway, I've done a separate video on Zoom's security concerns. I went through all of those. Should you be concerned or not? Should you still even be using Zoom or not? And if you're interested in that, then go ahead and check that video out on our channel. But today I'm actually covering off Google Meet and the announcement from Google, which is a big one, which is that Meet is actually going to be available for everyone. And so in kind of the background, Google have been continuously improving their product. You know, while Zoom has said, yes, you know, we've had this tremendous growth in our platform, Google's also had tremendous growth in their platform as well. There's actually been 30 times more people using, daily active users using Google Meet than there was at the start of this year, which is a massive increase. And I got to give credit to Google, no hacked accounts, no half a million accounts exposed on the dark web with usernames and passwords, no downtime or security issues. And you know, Zoom's really been having issues with that. Google obviously built on the power of Google Cloud. They know what they're doing with scaled infrastructure. They've been able to handle it really well. And so now what Google have been preparing in the background is actually starting to build out some of the features that haven't yet been there, that have been in Zoom, but have not yet been in Google Meet. So last week they actually announced a bunch of features that are gonna be built into Google Meet or have already been switched on inside of Google Meet. One of those is actually showing more people on the screen, and you can see here, here's a screenshot of my team when we were testing that out the other day. But they're also building in other features here, like there's a like a low light mode. That one's pretty cool. AI based noise cancellation, I really like that one. So if you've got background noises like dogs barking or you know clicks and whatnot from your computer, then they're going to start to take care of those as well. Now I've got to say, it's about bloody time because Zoom has been able to accelerate away in business communications by having these simple features that Google really should have built in before now, before they realized that they were really behind in the race with what's actually happened with Zoom completely taking off and really being the star of remote work during the current economic crisis. But not to fear, Google's tools, you know, Google does work a little bit slower sometimes, but Google's tools are always secure, they're always convenient, and what I love about Google is they're always deeply, deeply integrated into the G Suite system. So if you're a Google business, if you're using G Suite right now, you're absolutely nuts if you're not using Meet. Yeah, sure, you might use Zoom for one or two like external meetings, or if you wanna run a webinar and you can't do that with Google, but for any of your internal meetings, if you wanna be absolutely sure about your security and you wanna have the best integration with the best with the rest of the Google world, then I strongly recommend using Google Meet for everything. As we do internally, we've completely stopped using Zoom, as many other companies also have just banned its internal use because of security concerns. So I wanna take you guys through what this actual announcement means, because Google have basically said, hey, everyone's getting Meet, but what does that actually mean? So Google are announcing that Meet is being made available for everyone. And that means everyone with a Gmail address as well. So not just a G Suite address, everyone with a Gmail address. Now, it's in limited availability, so it's being rolled out over the next couple of weeks. And also, it's only going to be unlimited until September 30. So after September 30, 2020, there's going to be a 60-minute limit that's added in there as well. And then there will be, I'm assuming, some kind of paid plan that's going to come out for Google Meet if you still want to keep using it past the 60 minutes. But we don't have any public information that I can share about that with you right now. But Google have actually launched something called G Suite Essentials, which I'll tell you about in a moment. And that G Suite Essentials also includes Google Drive. And so Google Drive and Google Meet included together, without Mail, without Calendar, without the other apps, is going to form that G Suite Essentials product, which is pretty cool, brand new. We're going to do a separate video on that one to share a little bit more information about that. But for now, that's what's been announced. But the most important thing is that Meet is going to be free for everyone for the next 6 months, which is really cool. Means that anyone's going to be able to have the additional security of using Google Meet for their meetings. And if you're someone who's concerned about the security with Zoom, if you're doing any kind of business video conferencing, corporate meetings, if you're delivering some kind of telehealth and you want to make sure that your meetings are encrypted and properly secured, then Google Meet is a great option for that. So how do you use Google Meet? If you haven't used Google Meet before, it's really easy. You just literally go to meet.google.com in the browser. One of the best things about Google Meet is it all runs in the browser. There's no downloads, there's no apps to deal with. You don't have to like dial in on your phone. Even the Zoom app on your phone still has to like dial in, and it takes 5 seconds to join, whereas Google Meet is just like bang, instant. And if I want to create a meeting, I can just literally create a meeting here. I don't even have to put in a nickname or anything. And then I can grab that URL and basically then share that with anyone that I want to. So that literally happens instantly. I love it. Now, sharing URLs, that's one of the things that's really hurt Zoom, because people were guessing the URLs because it only used numbers and not letters, and then jumping into random people's meetings. And people were showing like porn to kids and all kinds of terrible things were happening. And so Google's meeting codes are much more secure, but Google never lets anyone join a meeting who's outside your company unless you admit them. Unless you click a button and actually let someone in, there's no way for someone to just randomly join a meeting with Google Meet. So that's one of the things, like one of the most basic security things that Google have done right. The flip side of that is that, Zoom meetings are easier to join because no one has to click the button to let you in. But Google have now obviously reversed that policy and actually switched on the waiting room, they call it, so that anyone who creates a meeting has to now manually approve people. Effectively the same thing that Google Meet does. So you go to meet.google.com and you get access to Google Meet. Now, there's a couple of things that Google Meet does that Zoom doesn't even do, which is pretty cool. One of those is the automatic transcription of your meetings. So down the bottom, when you're on a meeting, you can actually switch on captions and it will automatically caption your meetings using Google's amazing voice AI. It's like the best in the world. And so if you've got different people from different backgrounds or languages, or someone who may find it hard to hear and finds it easier to listen on with watch on with text, then you have those automated captions just happening there at the bottom of the meetings. Really, really cool feature, especially if you've got big, diverse groups who you're presenting to and you're not exactly sure who might be on the call. The second one is the recording. Now, you can record Zoom meetings as well, but the thing I love about Google Meet is that when you hit record and then you hit stop record, it automatically places that recording, which is encrypted, by the way, which Zoom can't say. The recording is encrypted and it's placed straight inside your Google Drive. And so it never really leaves the ecosystem of your protected Google account. And if you've got two-factor authentication switched on your Google account, then it is all nicely secured. Once you've downloaded the Meet app on your mobile phone, you can also join the Meets on your mobile phone, which is really cool. As I said, you don't have to like dial in or anything like that. You just click a button and you're in. But Google also has pretty neat integrations with Google Calendar. So if I'm actually creating a calendar event, I'm going to go ahead and open up my calendar here. Let me share my screen. If I create a, let's create a test event here. So test. So as soon as I add a guest, let's say I'll add Angel, my marketing manager, you can see it's automatically adding a Google Meet meeting there, and it's automatically going to have that attached to the calendar. And even if that person is outside my company, actually, it's going to automatically add a Google Meet link. Now, it works in Safari, it works in Chrome, so anyone who has the URL will be able to join the meeting, even if they're not inside your company, and they don't even have to dick around with any downloads or installing any apps or anything like that, of course, unless they're on the mobile. But running things out of the browser means that Meet is really great for, like, if you're doing telehealth, if you're doing business meetings with customers, internal or external from the company, or just, you know, meeting with anyone quickly and rapidly. One of my other favorite integrations is, I'll go ahead and open Google Chat here. If I'm in a Google Chat, so this is the Google Slack equivalent, lets you set up chat rooms, have different spaces for your team to be able to chat to each other, Giphy integration, you know, all kinds of cool stuff in there. We've got other videos on that if you're interested in it. But if I want to catch up with someone, I can just with one button, drop in a video meeting, hit return, and then bang, we're automatically jumping straight into a meeting. And so one of the things I love about the Google ecosystem is everything actually talks to each other. Oh, and there's one more thing I should probably show you that. Inside of Gmail now, there's actually a link to instantly create a meeting inside of Gmail there. So you can see there's a start meeting button or join meeting button. And they basically like automatically let you jump straight into a meeting. So love all of those integrations with everything in the Google world. Okay, so this is going to be unlimited from now until September 30. We will see what Google does from there forward with how they're going with that. They will most likely, you know, have some kind of paid plan, I guess, for their G Suite Essentials plan. And we will have another video coming up on G Suite Essentials on exactly what is included in that. But right now, if you haven't already, head along to meet.google.com. If you are using a Gmail account because you're not yet using G Suite, then you can register to be notified when your account will be switched on. That's going to happen over the next couple of weeks from the date that we've recorded this video. But then once everyone gets access to it, you can record your meetings, you can do all the cool other stuff inside of Google Meet. And of course, it's all backed and protected by the security of Google. And if you're already on G Suite and you have not switched on the enterprise features, then our team can help you out with that. And so if you're interested in G Suite Essentials, which gives you access to Google Drive, gives you access to Google Meet, if you're not yet ready to like do the full switch over to G Suite and change all your emails and migrate your mailboxes and do all that other stuff, if you're just interested in the G Suite Essentials product to get access to Meet, or maybe just to get access to Google Drive and start using some Google Docs and you know, try out how that works inside your team, then get in touch with us below. Don't go through the normal Google channels because you'll, you know, be in a big waiting list and there's a whole bunch of people trying to get access to it right now. Our team can help you get set up. So head along to the chat button down below this video, chat to our team at itGenius and say, I'm interested in G Suite Essentials, and our team will get you in touch with that. If you haven't heard of our 8-week remote work playbook, that is our 8-week online course for running remote companies. If you're interested in that, check out the link below. Otherwise, definitely want to enjoy joining our Remote Revolution group. That's all about business owners running remote companies and remote teams, helping you out there. And if you haven't yet joined our G Suite community, if you're already a G Suite customer and you want to connect with other business owners running G Suite and get our exclusive tips on that, then there's also a link to that group below. Until next time, take it easy, guys. Make sure you're subscribed, and we'll catch you in the next one. We'll have more updates with this as they are released from Google, and we'll be sharing all of that on our pages. So make sure you're subscribed to itgenius.tv. Take care. Cheers.